Welcome. It's the WNBA here on 2K Sports. In this game, we'll see the Phoenix Mercury going up against the Seattle Storm. Alongside Tim Schwartz and Brian Banifatemi, I'm Blake Suniga. Thanks for joining us. It'll be the Mercury off the tip. Outside, Diggin Smith, right wing. Rossi outside. Shot clock at six. Both loose.
The long three.
Bird pulls it in.
Sometimes you just want to show off your range.
I mean, we already know how good her range is, so I don't know why she's firing from that deep.
From deep, Skylar Diggin Smith. The basket good off the assist from Diana Taurasi.
What a passer. Diana Taurasi sees the game like few ever have. Finds teammates in great positions.
From the baseline, Bird gets the bucket. Here in the first with a little over a minute played so far. Pass to Breland. Coffey defended by Stewart. Now here's Diggin Smith. He's guarded closely. It's good on the putback.
You know, throughout her career, I don't think Griner's got the credit that she deserves for her effort. The second chance points she generates are just so huge. They show her hustle.
Now here's Howard. Here's Lloyd. And it's blocked by Diana Taurasi. Clock at four. Here's Stewart. And she'll shoot free throws. Clearly fouled on the shot that time. The whistle blows. And there's the call. Phoenix, the foul. She's getting her first free throw attempts of the night.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls.
When you think of Brianna Stewart, you think winner. She won four college championships, has an Olympic gold medal, and a WNBA title.
She's off on the second. And we're about 2 minutes into the first quarter.
Go, look this way.
Pass to Coffey. Reiner. Taurasi. Here's Coffey. Guarded by Howard. He's off from three.
The defender draped all over her. She just couldn't shake loose.
Here's Lloyd. Pulls back up. Drops in the layup for two. And this game is tied up now.
So few players in the WNBA will outwork Lloyd. The second chance. Bucket. It's really all about wanting it more.
Now here's Taurasi. Reiner, guarded by Russell. Taurasi outside, puts it up, cans the shot with nobody near her. Now about 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Bird outside, outside Lloyd. Back to Bird, six to shoot. Launches a three, but they'll get another chance. Russell with the bucket.
She was the first one to react to that miss. I mean, that's just a hustle play on the putback.
And here in the first quarter, a little over 3.5 minutes played. Taurasi, and that's good.
When you make more buckets than anybody in WNBA history, you have to score in the paint. Taurasi never scared inside.
Now here is Stewart. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and we'll shoot two at the line. It's going to be on Jessica Breland.
Brianna Stewart. Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And she can't get the first one. hits the second from the line. Phoenix in the lead. Pass to Griner. Coffee. Outside, Diggins Smith. Takes the 13-footer. Storm with the rebound. Inside. Stewart with the bucket.
At 6'4", with her abilities, it's almost impossible to stop Stewart down low.
Pass to Griner. Coffee. Now here's Diggins Smith. Reeland. Fades and shoots. And it's Brianna Stewart with the rebound. Here's Bird.
That's her second foul of the first quarter. Might want to sit her down for a while to avoid the third foul.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. And here is Lloyd. Stewart inside. Reeland defending. Five on the clock. Shot. Here's Stewart. It's not going to go for her. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. Hartley. A putback. She hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Phenomenal effort. Reeland creates scoring chances for herself by relentlessly working on the offensive glass.
And that one's good. Stewart.
You like to see it. She's been working really hard to get good looks, and it's paying off here early.
Hartley, left side.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jordan Canada.
That's her first foul. And so here's Phoenix. They trail by one. Back to Taurasi. Six on the shot clock. Three-pointer. Hartley's shot is off.
Yeah, and that's iffy shot selection there with the defender all over her.
Absolutely. You just can't rise up over the top when she's guarding you. The ball has to go somewhere else. Rebounding is going to be a focal point for them in this one, fellas.
Yeah, Brian, it has been so far. They've already got a nice edge on the glass. Always easily above 50% shooting from the floor. Griner is deadly inside.
Now here is Howard. Looking for her first basket still in this one. Pass to Russell. Over Griner. Russell misses.
A real defensive lapse there. She's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. They're lucky she didn't punish him there.
Here's Hartley. Here's Turner. Here's Walker Kimbrough, guarded by Canada. Walker Kimbrough misses. Seattle trailing here. Pass to Stewart. Howard. Outside Canada. Clock at six. Russell. It's stolen by Griner. Taurasi outside. On the shot.
A creative finisher. Taurasi uses her athleticism to create good looks for herself.
Lauren Canada drives in. Outside Stewart. Just five to shoot. The 11-footer. That shot by Canada, no good. Hartley outside. They get it back. Einer, that's in, and she's now 3-for-3 and looking sharp.
They need to get way more disruptive defensively. They just can't keep allowing these easy buckets. You know, get a little physical, show some effort.
Defensively, that's job number one. Effort, nothing easy inside.
Now here's Langhorne. To end the drought. And
such a strong defensive prowess. I love how Griner makes shooters think not once, not twice, probably at least three times before shooting the rock around her.
Here's Turner. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game.
Here's Griner.
Good. And the assist goes to Bria Hartley.
And now we see them really working it inside.
Yeah, getting quality looks around the rim. That's fueling this run.
Now here is Canada. Outside Whitcomb. Fires for three. Turner grabs the board. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Mercury out in front, leading by seven. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. And what do you guys think about the Mercury here in this one?
Good effort. Very tight defense from them through the first quarter.
Really a big part of why they're up right now. You know, their defense has been on point.
And here are the Storm now. 7-point differential. Clark outside. So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there.
A solid free throw shooter. Clark wants every part of her game to be advanced.
It's her first trip to the line.
At the line for two. Shooting two.
And the first one falls for her.
17th pick in the 2010 WNBA draft. Clark has carved out a nice career for herself. I like her game.
And good on both. Phoenix leading. Here's Turner. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Floats one up. Rejected by Alicia Clark. To the middle. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot, and we'll go to the line.
At the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
She knocks down the first one.
This is the way to stay in the game. They're doing a masterful job from the line here.
And that's good as she hits both shots. Now Hartley. Pass to Turner. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Six on the shot clock. Now Griner. From deep. And it's Turner missing. And we played just over a minute of basketball in the second quarter. On the wing, Sammy Whitcomb. Releases. Griner with the rebound. And here the Mercury. 3-point lead. Outside. Poked away. Pass to Whitcomb. Banked in off the glass.
Ran her defender straight into that screen to open up the lane to the hoop.
Timeout called the Mercury.
Yeah, coaches, they saw their team giving up a lot of points and wanted to get a break before it got out of hand.
And that's a big part of a coach's job, making sure you keep your players in the best position possible at all times. That's a great timeout.
Second quarter of play with around 2 minutes gone so far. Pass to Griner. Coffee. Here's Turner. Six to shoot. Here's Griner. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
Sometimes you look at Brittany Griner and you think she is an unstoppable force. A little bump, it doesn't do anything to stop her. She's so locked in on scoring.
Now here is Stewart. 6 points for her. And here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played.
Driving to the hoop and drawing the foul. Stewart's a sharp basketball player.
We've seen her miss a couple from the line, going 2 for 4 so far.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And she makes the first. So she gets them both. Here's Diggin Smith. 3 minutes of action thus far in the second quarter. Griner up top. Yes, and it's Skylar Diggins-Smith with the assist that time.
But when you get this kind of shooting from her, 100% from the field, I mean, they're a tough team to beat. Anybody's tough to beat.
On the wing, Jewel Lloyd. Pulls up on the elbow. Second shot opportunity. And Jessica Breland with the block. Here's Coffey, defended by Stewart. Pass to Turner. Now Griner.
Way to get to the line. Griner lives off not just getting to the line, but she shoots over 80% at the line, too.
First trip to the line for her here. The first free throw is good.
A recurring WNBA All-Star, Griner's really made her mark in this league.
So she's able to get one of two. The Storm trail. Bird outside. Clark outside. Pass to Russell. Bird outside. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Breland. And the Storm miss again. It's stolen by Natasha Howard. Bird with it. Lloyd. Shot clock at 6. Right side, Howard. Shoots over Diggins Smith. Howard gets the bucket.
You like to get maybe a degree of difficulty bonus there for Howard. Great concentration to put it through the hoop.
Pass to Taurasi. And here's Griner. Here's Breland. That's good, and so Brittany Griner gets the assist. Here's Seattle, trailing by four. Bird, guarded by Diggins-Smith. Howard can't get it to go.
Not pretty. Got to just shake off a miss like that.
And the call will go against Jewel Ward. That's her first foul. And so here's Phoenix. Taurasi outside. And foul called as she misses. And she can shoot two free throws. It's on Mercedes Russell.
A steady and consistent scoring threat. Taurasi isn't really afraid to use her body down low.
And the first one drops.
Simply, she's a once-in-a-generation player. Taurasi is not only the all-time leading scorer in WNBA history, she's also top five in assists. Offensively, defensively, everything. She's done it all.
And good on the second, so she makes both.
And they're getting more free throw points here in the second quarter.
One of the reasons they're in front right now, definitely.
Outside Lloyd. And drops for her second main shot this game. An unimpressive 2-for-7.
Well, she's never one of the taller players in the lane, but Lloyd's crafty moves help her get buckets down low.
Now here's Taurasi. She's got 8. Count it.
Really, that's her strong suit, the ability to find a way through the D and finish at the rim.
And it's the Storm with the ball. 6-point game. Here's Bird. The shot that time, not on target. Jessica Breland with some nice D. Pass to Diggins-Smith. Here's Coffey, guarded by Bird. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Can't get the 3 to fall.
Even with the decent coverage that time, she has every bit of confidence to drill that 3.
Absolutely. Just keep shooting. I wouldn't bet against her the next time she's in that situation.
Now here's Bird. 5 to shoot. That falls. Nice feed that time from Drew Lloyd.
You just marvel at what Bird does. She doesn't let the D affect her. Total focus on getting the points.
The floater. A nice shot by Diggins-Smith. And here are the Storm now. They trail by 6. Bird outside. Down low, Lloyd. The lead pass was put in just the right spot to produce the layup.
Some defensive breakdowns happening now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these high percentage shot attempts, it's not going to get it done. They need to figure it out.
And it's out of bounds to the Mercury as Phoenix retains possession. So both teams changing it up here. Shot clock at 5. And here's Diana Taurasi from the arc. The Mercury with another miss.
Not only is the game neck and neck, but the rebounding battle is too. Very tight game on the boards.
Yeah, both teams have put in a terrific effort down low.
Now here's Taurasi. 10 points for her. Hartley outside. Back to Taurasi. 8 feet out. Whitcomb grabs the miss.
It's been a bit of a struggle for her this quarter in terms of scoring the ball.
Pass to Canada. Now here's Howard. Clark outside. Now Canada. The 3 is up. That shot off. And here's Breland. Whitcomb defending.
Absolutely no fear, guys. Mixing it up in the paint with bigger players.
To Howard. Pass to Canada. to the paint. Howard gets the bucket. And it's all knotted up.
A career 50% shooter, Howard loves the inside looks.
2-for-1 chance here.
Let's see if they use the clock to their advantage.
Here's Coffey. Now Breland. He's covered by Clark. Knocked away. It's stolen by Howard. And Jessica Breland with the block.
Well, with strong defensive instincts and awareness, Breland has become a respected shot blocker.
Hartley controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
I like the aggression there. Yeah, hitting the offensive boards hard.
Here's Canada. Oh, no good trying to beat the buzzer. And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going on here. Mercury out in front, leading by just 2. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. And you know, Griner has been really making it happen here.
Well, I think it'll be important to see if they can stop her down in the second half, because so far they have not had any answer for her when she's down on the block.
Yeah, maybe mixing up her looks, bumping her out, front her, double down, just do something to throw her off her rhythm.
Welcome back. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. Pass to Stewart. Russell. Great positioning on the putback.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
It doesn't matter how good that perimeter defense is if they keep allowing easy looks inside.
Here's Diggin Smith. The high floater.
Mechanically sound, even on unconventional shots. And Diggin Smith does a pretty good job of playing to her strengths.
Now here's Howard. Bird outside. 4 on the shot clock. Stewart. Yes. And a nice assist from Sue Bird.
Getting easy buckets for teammates. That's what Sue Bird does. And she's been doing it for a long time.
Now here's Diggin Smith, guarded by Bird. Here's Coffey. No good from three-point territory. Here is Lloyd, guarded closely for the lead. Here's Howard, and that misses. That would have put them up to the inside. Up again. It's good on the putback.
The combination of a long frame and a unique skill set make Griner such a tough cover for opponents.
Now here's Bird. Outside Stewart. Pass to Lloyd. Shoots over Taurasi. It's rebounded by Phoenix. Down low. Here's Griner. And she was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws for her. It's on Mercedes Russell.
An elite athlete for a player of her build. Griner's willing to battle on the interior.
And this is her 3rd and 4th free throw attempts of the game here.
Shooting 2.
good.
Both good at the line. Seattle trailing here.
They're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Lloyd
laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
The body control on her is tremendous. Lloyd is not easily taken off her game. Impressive make.
Now here's Diggins-Smith, guarded by Bird.
Terrific job defending the basket that time. It's not an easy task stopping her when she's headed to the rim.
And the basket by Lloyd.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Everybody always thinks it's passing that gets you assists, but also their movement off the ball, it's created those opportunities.
Bird, no good.
That's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always so important to have that strong interior defense.
To the paint. Reiner, guarded by Bird. Here's Walker Kimbrough. That's good. And so Brittany Griner gets the assist.
Ooh, an unselfish play from an unselfish player. Griner is a respected locker room pick.
Seattle calls timeout. Nice game. Great performance by Brittany Griner.
She has absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit the damage she's doing inside.
Second half here, and we're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Pass to Howard. Stewart. Back to Howard. That shot off. And the Mercury going the other way now. Here's Walker Kimbrough, covered by Lloyd. Coffee. Six to shoot. Shot from the low block. Turner with the bucket.
Easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
Outside Stewart. And the layup's good off the glass.
Well, it's pretty simple. You can't let Stewart get to the hoop. She's too tall and skilled to stop.
Here's Coffey. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. Here's Turner, defended by Stewart. And there's a whistle. That's going to go on Brianna Stewart. That is her first foul of the game. Seattle on D. It's a three-point game. Pass to Griner. Just 5 on the clock. Lays it up and banks it in.
A nice conclusion to a good-looking possession. Coach has got to be happy about that one.
Langhorne with the ball. She's guarded by Hartley. Outside Canada. From beyond the arc, nails the tray! Here the Mercury. The lead is 2. Pass to Griner. It's good for her 8th straight basket in only 8 attempts.
Well, her shooting has been outstanding. Definitely, you know, one of the reasons why they're winning this game.
And here is Stewart. Now here is Howard. She has 6. Playing along the right side. Just for a shoot. by Brittany Griner.
And they turn it over. 24 seconds buzzer signaling the shot clock violations.
Alicia Clark.
And here is Hartley. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Griner. And it's Seattle with the rebound. Clark left side. Now Canada. Clark. Outside Stewart. Four on the clock. And she banks in the layup. Here's Turner. Pass to Coffey. Walker Kimbrough. Now here's Hartley.
Covered by Langhorne.
The floater. That one is off.
Good work defensively by Sammy Whitcomb.
Canada with it. Back to Whitcomb. To the middle. Here's Stewart.
What a great sight to see. Stewart doesn't need much to get going, and once she does, she is so tough to guard.
And the Mercury call time here.
Nice game, great performance by Stewart.
She continues to burn him at the offensive end. The coaching staff is gonna have to make an adjustment.
Turner. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Out to the wing. Pass to Griner. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And this is her third trip to the line tonight.
Two shots. Shooting two.
Teams deciding to change it up. And she sinks the second.
Even with the miss, she got the big one there to put them in front.
Pass to Stewart. Clark. Canada. He's covered by Taurasi. Outside Canada. Shoots over Taurasi. And a shot by Canada. No good. Now Hartley. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Makes it off the glass.
After leaning on the three-point shot in the first half, they're starting to get away from it here in the second. More of their shots are coming from inside.
Now here is Canada. Here's Lloyd. And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
Consistently in the top 10 in free throws made, Lloyd knows how to bait defenders. Very high IQ.
And first trip to the free throw line for her in this one. And the first one at the line is good.
Really arriving on the international stage, Lloyd was part of the 2018 national team, helping the team win the world championships in Spain.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time. Phoenix in the lead. Taurasi outside. Pass to Griner, to the wing, right side. Here's
Hartley. The bucket is good, and she'll have a chance for one more.
It's on Mercedes Russell. Canada. Pass to Stewart. Clark. Canada with it. Russell. He's guarded by Griner. And the Storm miss again. And so here's Phoenix. A 4-point game. And here's Taurasi. Yes, and it's Rhea Hartley picking up the assist.
One of the most daring scorers in the league, Taurasi excels at finding ways to score despite tight defense.
Stewart with the ball. 16 points for her. Out to the right wing. Here's Canada.
Buries it from outside.
Great job to find the open teammate. Stewie has very solid vision.
And we have just finished the third quarter and a tight game we've got. It's the Mercury up 3. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get set for the fourth quarter. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, this is what being on the same page looks like. Fantastic feed and a heads-up play all around.
And how can you not be a fan of a sequence like that? This is what beautiful basketball is all about.
Yeah, unselfishness, just wonderful stuff.
And thanks for joining us again as the fourth quarter of play is set to get rolling. It's been a close battle to this point. Now here's Taurasi. Outside for Diggins-Smith.
And again, Phoenix with the triple.
A part of Diggins-Smith's game that she continues to work on, but a fiery competitor like her never sets limits on what they can and can't do.
That one goes. Count it.
What an alert play. Just a great job of hitting her teammate on the move.
Pass to Hartley. Now here is Breland. The basket. She was fouled, and she's going to the line for one more.
Good shot.
Storm trail. Outside Canada. Pass to Lloyd. Clark. And here's Canada. He's covered by Taurasi. The shot by Canada, no good.
A good board there, but overall, they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
And they've just got to find a way to get back into this game. That's as good a place as any.
Just increase the effort on the boards.
Now here is Canada. The rebound by Brittany Griner. Pass to Hartley. Baseline try. Good D by Jordan Canada.
Well, you love the closeout there.
Yeah, she made that a very tough shot. Nice active defense.
And it's Lloyd missing.
The defense was ready for her, got a hand in her face, and made that one much tougher.
And that's something that every team needs, rugged interior defense to just make your opponent think twice about coming down the lane.
Now here is Breland, down to 5 on the shot clock. Jordan Canada loses a block. And it's going to be a 24-second violation. They'll turn it over.
Natasha Howard.
storm now.
They trail by 9 points.
Seattle calls timeout.
Looks like the coach saw some things out there that need adjusting, and it's going to take a little time to talk it over.
Yeah, never a bad idea to use a timeout if there's something that's got you concerned.
Fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Outside Howard. Pass to Canada. 5 on the clock. Russell. He's guarded by Griner. Fades back. Russell with the bucket.
Whatever their plan was defensively that time, it did not work. Not if it results in that shot.
Coffee. Now Griner, covered by Lloyd. Rossi outside, drills it from outside.
Well, she's the all-time leader in threes made in league history. You might not want to let Diana Taurasi get off shots from range.
Now here is Canada. Inside, Russell. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner. And a fast break now for the Mercury. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots. Next.
Two shots. Wow. Elbow. Two. Shooting two.
Difference this half is when they get to the line, they're making their free throws.
And she can't with the second. And it's the Storm with the ball. 11-point game. Howard, pass to Bird. Russell shoots the three. Freeland grabs the miss.
Just like me, 9 times out of 10, she's gonna bury the three when she's left all alone.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good.
She has made an effort here to get into the defense more and create some contact opportunities. And for the most part, she's succeeding.
On that one, so she goes 1 for 2 at the line. Here's Bird. Soft touch off the glass.
A player who just enjoys to run. Bird knows how hard it is to score in the half court, so getting a hoop in transition, she knows it's a gift.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Here's Freeland. It's good.
Give an assist there, not for a pass, but for the solid screen set on the inside that freed her up and really just made that layup possible.
Pass to Lloyd. Howard with the ball. She's covered by Taurasi.
And that's a foul called on to Rossi. And that's her first foul. Outside Lloyd. Shoots over to Rossi.
Energy and quickness made Taurasi a pest on that play. I love to see that type of defensive intensity.
Pass to Coffey. Now here's Griner, defended by Stewart. Griner, good.
Well, they built this lead through plays exactly like that. She's easily been the most consistent performer.
No question about that. I mean, she's just hitting everything in sight.
Now here's Bird. Out to Lloyd. No good on the three.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor. It's all adding up.
Well, you look across the team stats, it's one of many areas they're winning, and they've secured a big lead.
It looks very sharp tonight.
I'm loving it.
Now here's Higgins-Smith. Good on the bucket.
Three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The defense better start buckling down.
They're getting exposed and punished down low.
Here's Stewart. Pass to Bird. Five to shoot. Back to Stewart.
They need this.
Mercury with the rebound.
That's definitely a situation where you want to make sure you don't give her too good of a look.
Absolutely. And the defense better not relax, because she might hit that one next time.
Here's Coffey. Reiner guarded by Russell.
Wow, it is a huge day on the glass for a player who's, you know what, they're giving up a lot of size to bigger players out there. Very impressive. With the size advantage as big as it was right there, that's exactly what she should do in that situation. Take it strong to the middle.
Now here's Higgins-Smith. Diana Taurasi on the wing. That's tipped. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Took advantage of some shoddy D there. They gotta at least get a finger on her.
Seattle calls timeout.
Coach saw that the players were getting a little run down out there. The timeout should give them a little energy back.
Player of the game, Brittany Griner.
Just operating at a higher level than anyone else on the floor. You have to appreciate her commitment to excellence. Terrific talent, and she puts in the work.
Well, she's a player you know you can count on in not just big games, but big moments. She loves the pressure, and that was evident tonight.
A difficult situation for Seattle. Outside Lloyd. Off target from outside.
You know, she's disappeared this quarter, not making a mark at all with her offense.
And you know she'll be happy to get this period over and done with and just start fresh.
Stewart grabs the miss. And it's the Storm with the ball. Here's Canada. And it's blocked by Skylar Diggins-Smith. Pass to Stewart. Second chance shot. No good that time. Nice D from Diana Taurasi. Outside Diggins-Smith. And here's Breland. Now Taurasi. Pass to Coffey. Let's go with a three. He can't hit that time. Seattle with the ball. They trail by 16. Here's Stewart. She's covered by Taurasi. Outside Howard. Canada. Russell. Guarded by Russell. Outside Diggins Smith. Pass to Taurasi. Here's Coffey. And here is Diggins Smith. Covered by Lloyd. Now here's Griner. She's covered closely. Not really her range, and that's off target. It's 2 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for the three-point play. Going to the line for one.
Voted most improved player in 2018, Natasha Howard shot 55% from the field, easily set a career scoring average mark, and was on the all-defensive team.
Here's Turner. And so it's Phoenix easily grabbing this one.